There's a threat in the world today. A threat to our way of living, a threat to our society, and maybe even a threat to our very existence. And what is this threat? The West Side Connection. An organization made up of highly motivated, extremely aggressive gangsters turned businessmen with one single objective: world domination, or in their words, creating a worldwide West Side.
Bang. Bang.
Call it Nicaragua.
I ain't no punk, I'm suited and booted, ready for war.
Like a lion in the jungle with heart, king of the throne.
Medals for courage, courage for medals.
Cause we can't look back, cause we stay on the pedal. I'm keeping it shaking, rocking and rolling. I keep my eyes peeled so I know where I'm going. Cause niggas try to blind you with all the hate. It's mandatory that I stay strong, hard in the pain. Cause I ain't worried about whoop-de-whooping them at this time. I give everybody respect till they cross that line. My mama always told me that the world be mine. So this ain't what you want.
You don't want these problems.
This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want.
Thank you. It's that new shit, we call it gutter funk. Get your walk on, nigga, get crunk. It's that gangster shit that niggas want. Pop your trunk and let your subwoofers bump. It's that new shit, we call it gutter funk.
Yeah!
Interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
Chicanos are marching to protest the high casualty rate of our people in Vietnam. We have suffered 22% of all casualties in Vietnam, yet we only make up 5% of the total population here in the United States. The Chicano people, through our moratorium, are saying now that the front line for Chicano youth is not in Vietnam, but in the struggle for social justice here in the barrios of the United States.
A moratorium. This is for la raza. Yes, for us. And for the world to see. Because today is a day of history for all of la raza. Wherever they are. Throughout Latin America, throughout Mexico, wherever brown people exist. Today is a day of history. And from this day on, La raza mexicana shall be history.
Before, the people were divided very much, especially during the Pachuco days. Chicano would be fighting Chicano. Now I see unity. Like now you can go from one barrio to another and you're brothers. And this is really beautiful to see people united and fighting for the same cause.
The Brown Berets evolved out of the movement in the Chicano community for social justice. The Brown Berets are a community organization that give new pride to Chicano youth and that educate all the people in the barrios on their social and political rights.
Our culture, our history, and our contributions. And we've been allowing it. And we've been going over there and trying to act like somebody we're not. And we've been trying to, some of the cats are even trying to sing like James Brown, you know, because they're not identifying with their own culture. That's all right, soul music is beautiful. And we should be able to integrate that and enjoy it. But Chicano soul music is beautiful too. Sinatra, Dean Martin, walking around like Steve McQueen and John Wayne, you know, trying to identify with somebody they're not, allowing this society to castrate us, to make us less a man. Because anytime you don't know who you are, anytime you don't know where you come from, anytime that you deny your mother and your father, the cat that don't have no father, you know what he is. And any time that you deny your own identity, you don't know who you are. You have no value, you have no worth. Thank you.
Raza Unida Party crystallized the sense of nationalism, or a culmination of nationalism, I could put it that way. And a lot of my compañeras and compañeros consequently began to say, you know what, we need to manifest our movement's mission and goals in art form. We're talking about politics and talking about struggle and power, but we're talking about art form and poetry and talking about writing, you know, and it was a very psychological liberating force, what I call the decolonizing of our minds, to not only promote an identity of Chicanismo or, you know, who we were as an indigenous people, but more importantly, as creators.
Santana, how did you start your group and how did you came to music?
The answer is, man.
Just by watching what it does to people. Music attracts me by watching what it does to people, what it does to a whole environment. As soon as music gets in the air, the first time I saw it, you see the people changing, the moods, the way they talk, the whole environment. It comes more naturally. People are more themselves than what they are programmed to be.
I used to cruise a lowrider, a Firme 63 Bel Air, and everything was original except for the hydros. I even took the pilgrimage to Española, New Mexico, the lowrider capital of the world, and I got respeto for my ranfla. But that's not what being Chicano is all about. I remember when I was a cholo with the creases in my khakis, razor sharp, tattoos y todo, and my penalty unbuttoned at the top, and those corduroy bedroom slippers. You remember those chopos? And that grease I put in my hair, tres flores. I had a three-finger habit, and that stuff, it kicks my hair back just right every night, and it never completely washes out. But that's not what being Chicano is all about. Then I learned my Chicano history about Cesar, Che, Tijerina, Aztlan, the walkouts, the boycotts, the riots, the resistance. And I was angry that I wasn't taught all this in school. But I still hadn't figured out what being Chicano is all about. Then I became a militant Chicano with my fist in the air. I was ready to conquer the establishment. I started spelling the word Chicano with an X because that's the way the Mexica would have spelled it. I stood at the pinnacle of the pyramid of the sun, and I was ready to throw myself to the bottom for any cause. But I still hadn't figured out what being Chicano is all about. I never got a tattoo teardrop. I never got mi vida loca tattooed between my thumb and my finger. I never did a drive-by or spray-painted my placa on the wall, but that has nothing to do with what it is to be Chicano. Chicano is the fire that feeds my soul. It's the blood of my ancestors racing through my veins. It's the passion in my heart. Chicano is the love for mi familia. Chicano is the love for mi cultura. Chicano is the love for mi raza. It's about having respeto, respect. It's about being humble, but knowing when to fight. Chicano is the burning that's inside me, that moves me, that motivates me, that makes me who I am.